me ask you a question. We're hearing all about these solar companies coming to Arizona because they did that huge tax credit and incentive. Well, which, stop and think about that for a minute. Of the 50 states, which state do you think should be able to attract a solar company without a tax incentive? This shows you how messed up our tax regulatory environment is. We are the fourth most expensive state for all commercial property tax, not just the personal property tax. We used to be the third highest. I worked when I was in the legislature to lower the commercial property tax that's holding us back. Why didn't it take a special incentive to get solar companies here? Why do we not have a diversified industrial base? Because we have high commercial property taxes. As a result, capital-intensive businesses find it very difficult to locate here unless they absolutely have to be here, like mining, or they are big and powerful enough to get a special carve-out. We need to end this process. We need to bring down our property taxes across the board. Now, that it would have been nice to have had some help on this over the last 10 years, but we had to fight Napolitano. Didn't have any support. We were able to get some progress. We were able to go from third to fourth, and we would have been down to fifth, and we'll head our way to sixth if it wasn't for this $250 million property tax increase. But on top of that, we've got to get our property taxes under control, but more importantly, we have to get our spending under control as the state. I don't care what incentives, I don't care what type of benefits you plan on handing out or relief, no one's gonna believe you if you're still renting your own Capitol building. You've got to get your own fiscal house in order first before you can get the second thing, which is creating a job-friendly environment. Thank you.
On immigration, we have all these problems with the health bill coming down. Some folks in Washington want to give amnesty to the existing ones. I believe we did that 25 years ago, and it didn't work. How do you stand, and where are you going to stop the continual drain that these undocumented are putting on our society, i.e. in the access and the health care, and NAFTA? Do you believe this is part of the problem through NAFTA and the North American Union? And that we will start with Mr. Martin.
Well, you heard Obama cut the fence out of the budget, and they're laying off hundreds of Border Patrol agents. Last I heard, the number was somewhere around 180 just here in Arizona alone. You know, Napolitano used to say, show me a 30-foot ladder, show me a 30-foot fence, I'll show you a 31-foot ladder. Well, I can tell you it's a lot easier to find a guy running through the desert with a 31-foot ladder. Since they're heavy. If the federal government isn't going to do its job, if they're not going to meet their responsibility, this is still our state. These are our neighborhoods. State of Arizona. It was 6-8 years ago, I worked with a number of my colleagues to try to get the National Guard deployed to the border, and they all thought we were crazy. A couple years later, the governor does it in her own stunt, but she doesn't let them take any weapons with them. What good's a soldier without their weapon? Then we tried to put the radar and camera systems that they use in the Barry Goldwater bombing range on the border. Governor Napolitano vetoed it. That was legislation I co-sponsored, put that on the border. We can do this. It will cost us a few million bucks, but it's costing us billions not doing it. We must secure our border. It's a cheap investment. We need to also remember it's illegal immigration we need to focus on, not legal immigration. That's why we need to be enforcing our border. It's much, much more effective to do it that way.
Mr. Munger.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a right to enforce the sovereignty of our state, and that includes if the federal government will not enforce and secure our borders, then we will do that, and I will do that. And I will do it two ways specifically. Number one, we have a National Guard, the portion of the National Guard which has not yet been federalized. We will send them to the border for my first day in office. We will send them armed this time, and we will secure that portion of the border the federal government has not secured. Second of all, and I have talked to Sheriff Joe about this, the police forces in this state can handle and take off the street the illegals that are already here. Their problem is they're punching a sponge, ladies and gentlemen. Every time they take one off the street, there's more coming across the border. And incidentally, they're not coming across with 31-foot ladders. They're coming across in trucks. They're coming across with coyotes, with Uzis. Okay? They're coming across in mass. Who brings them across? The drug and human smuggling cartels, ladies and gentlemen. This governor is going to, on the first day of office, announce that the time for business in the state of Arizona of the human smuggling drug cartels is over. And we are going to recruit and train and equip a major task force of the DPS, and we are going to take them out. Well, that happens, ladies and gentlemen. Our neighborhoods are in danger. The problem will never stop until we stop the profiteers from this problem. And I will do that as governor. And then when they take people off the street, they won't be punching a sponge. There will be nobody else coming in. Thank you.
Thank you. Buzz, never say that. I never gave you the last word.
Last word. Thank you, Tom. They've done it again. The feds have failed us again. Once more, in spite of all of the do good and 10th Amendment violations where they want to manage our lives right down to the last thing. They failed us on the border. Again, they're just not stopping the problem. Now, as soon as these folks get across the border, they head to sanctuary cities. As governor, we need to put a lot of pressure on the sanctuary cities so these folks are not comfortable in that town. They're gonna have to go. In 2004, the legislature passed and the governor signed a bill to deny benefits. Why aren't we denying benefits? State benefits, federal benefits. We don't enforce the law we have, for God's sake. And then you've got every time we have somebody like Sheriff Joe who enforces the law, they want to come in and have a big investigation. That's not helping the problem. We have National Guard. We can put them on the border. We can take care. We need to bring some home. Yeah, do that. And we need to have them on the border to protect our state sovereignty. You know, the feds aren't going to do it. We're going to have to do it ourselves. So we can do that. There's a number of other issues that we can do to bring pressure on the legislators. We have a provision in the law whereby we can get money back from the feds, and not everybody is getting as much back as we should. It's their responsibility. The money we're spending $1 billion a year on this project. Am I done? Postforgov.com.